All set? All right, well, good morning. We wanted to provide you with another briefing and some more updates in reference to the shooting last night at the Plaza Lot. So about 10:30 last night, we received multiple calls about shots being fired from inside the plaza. Our officers responded within 2 minutes and immediately cleared the scene and secured the scene, and inside found two people that had been shot. So based on our investigation thus far, it appears that a white male, 21 years of age, approached Christina Grimmie. This was after the show. There were about 120 people inside the plaza, and she was doing like a meet and greet, you know, signing autographs and selling merchandise. So this white male approached her and opened fire, striking her. At that, almost immediately, her brother Marcus Grimmie tackled the suspect to the ground. Shortly after that, the suspect killed himself. And obviously, as we know, unfortunately, Christina Grimmie succumbed to those gunshot wounds that passed. Our thoughts and prayers are with the family and friends and fans of Christina, and our detectives are meeting with her parents today. The suspect in this case is not from Orlando. The suspect traveled to Orlando, apparently to commit this crime, and then had plans to travel back to where he came from. So what we're doing at this point, we're not identifying his name right now, but we will have that shortly for you near the end of the day. What our detectives are doing right now is they're going through the suspect's cell phone and computer to see if they could find a motive for this crime. The suspect had two handguns on his person. He had two additional loaded magazines for those handguns and a large hunting knife. So at this time, we will take a few questions, but bear in mind that it is a very active investigation, and we may not be able to answer all of your questions.
Where did he come from?
Can you discuss the logistics of what was going on, his entry, what he encountered going in terms of security, and then where exactly this occurred inside?
Right. As far as security, the plaza does have security guards who wear polo shirts. They are unarmed. They do check bags and purses as people enter.
And then how far did he have to go from the door? Just, can you describe a little more of the actual scene?
Is it in the back, Jay? In the back? Where did it happen? Inside, in the back or in the front?
It happened at the end of the concert. It happened in the back of the hall, all the way in the back by the doors that exit.
Chief, is there any indication that he knew her or that they knew each other?
No, there's no indication that he knew her. We're looking into that and trying to find a motive for the crime.
Chief, you say people's bags are searched. Are they patted down? Do they go through any sort of type of metal detector?
There are no metal detectors. As far as I'm aware, the people are not patted down. I'm told that the security measures in place are that the people open their bags and the security people look inside those bags for weapons.
Does this person have a restraining order in any way or any kind of history of stalking or anything related?
Not that we know of at this time.
A couple questions. Where did he drive from? Well, first of all, did he drive or fly? And were the guns that he had legal? Were they registered to him?
We are taking a look at the guns right now to see where they came from. I will say that he traveled here from Florida, from another city in Florida to here, and had plans to travel back to that city. That's all I'm going to say about exactly where he's from right now.
Did he ever contact her on any social media or Twitter posts or anything to your knowledge right now?
Not to my knowledge, and that's what we're hoping to find in the phone. Maybe that will lead us to a motive of why he did this, but that's where we'll look through his phone and also his computer.
Have you had issues like this before? Any kind of calls of service out here? Has this been an issue?
No, we have never had an issue here that I'm aware of, especially anything of this magnitude. No issues like that.
Does the suspect have any prior criminal history or also any mental health issues?
None that we've located thus far.
So none that we've located thus far.
The suspect who took his life, was it an accidental discharge in the scuffle with the brother, or did he mean to take his life?
That's all part of the investigation.
Can you confirm for us that she was shot in the head, and was... It sounds like this was a targeted. He came here to do this. Can you explain a little bit more about that for us?
It does appear that he came here to commit this crime, yes.
And can you confirm that she was shot in the head for us?
We're not going to confirm that right now because we haven't met with her family yet, and we need to go over the details with them first.
Yeah, so detectives are meeting with her family later today.
Do you have an approximate time hour when we will know the suspect's identity?
I don't have a time hour, but it'll be later today. But our plans are to get you that information as quickly as possible. And like I said, we want to go through the phone and go through the computer and search the residence, all that as well. So there's a travel challenge for our detectives, but we're working on all that.
After other events locally recently, there's been a lot of discussion about club security. Do you know if they have made any changes recently or have planned to introduce any changes?
I'm not aware of any changes, but I think it's important to note the type of crowd that attends this. We're talking about young kids. This isn't a crowd that you would suspect would be carrying guns into a venue like this.
Can you comment about the brother and his heroic actions preventing that shooter from doing anything more than what he did?
Absolutely. You know, like I said, the suspect was armed with two handguns, had additional magazines, unknown what his plans were for after killing Christina, but very heroic actions by Marcus Grimmie to jump in and definitely could have prevented future loss of life there.
How old's your brother?
I'm not sure.
I know you said you're still searching for a motive, but is the hunch that this was just a deranged band?
That'd be speculation, but that's what it's looking like. I mean, we believe he came here to commit this crime.
Did this happen in front of a number of fans and eyewitnesses?
Yeah, there are multiple witnesses who saw this.
How many people?
About 120 people were in. The show was over, but like I said, they were doing a meet and greet, selling merchandise, signing autographs. So about 120 people inside the club.
Did you say whether this was backstage?
It's not. Was it backstage?
No.
No, it was not backstage.
Do you believe he attended the concert and the performance, or he just showed up afterwards?
Not sure. That's all part of the investigation.
Are you working with any other police departments? You said he's from a different city. In a different part of Florida right now, so are there law enforcement officers doing a search of his apartment or of his house or any kind of property that you might own to find more details?
Well, certainly anytime we have a suspect that's not from our jurisdiction, we do get the assistance from other jurisdictions. But we would be doing all that searching.
Did he drive here or did he fly here?
I'm not going to say it this time.
And then, so you just said that you would be doing the searches. Do you have officers in another city right now doing searches of his apartment or anything to that effect?
Yeah, I'm not going to say it this time right now.
Chief, can you tell us what information you have that led you all to believe that he came here specifically just?
That'll all come out later, but we can tell you that he came here to commit this crime and had plans to travel back to where he came from.
And just to be clear, am I understanding the venue was not last night employing any off-duty LEOs of any?
Right. There were no extra-duty police officers, no off-duty police officers at this venue last night.
Did he have a note or anything in his car or anything like that that might explain anything?
We're still looking through everything, but I'm not aware of any note or anything like that. And I think we're hoping that once we are able to get into the phone and into the computer, that it will shed some light on why he did this.
What exactly
he had a computer
are you
with
hoping
him.
It's going to say?
No, I'll talk about computer, maybe where he lives and all that.
Do you think it'll have a manifesto? Is that what you're hoping to get?
Oh, anything. Maybe contact on social media. Everything. You know, our lives are always now on our phones, so we're thinking that will hopefully lead us in the right direction to find a motive for this crime. Not that I'm aware of yet.
Chief, have you explained why you're not naming the suspect? I don't know if I just couldn't hear it over the van.
Yeah, we want to have the opportunity. Like I said, the suspect is from another jurisdiction, so there's a travel challenge for us. We just want to give the detectives time to complete this preliminary investigation as far as the search of the suspect's homes, cars, and everything involved in that, as well as all the suspect's electronic material.
Are there surveillance video taken in the club last night?
I'm not sure.
When you say outside of Florida, do you mean Central Florida or outside of Central Florida? Since we've got nine counties in our specific area.
Outside of Central Florida.
Outside of
right.
Central Florida.
Do you know if you have video?
Do
you know or do you know? And just to answer that, there is no video that we're aware of.
Are you contacting
the shooter's family next to him?
Yes.
They're cooperating?
Yes.
No,
not at this time. But like I said, we'll We'll probably have that towards before the end of the day. We'll get that from you to you. So we know people want some answers to these questions of why this person may have done that and who this person is. So we're going to get you that information as quickly as we can without trying to interfere with the detective's investigation.
You guys believe that he was getting ready to travel back when he basically committed suicide. Is there any idea that he got scared and this happened?
No, that would only be speculation because, you know, maybe he wasn't planning on being tackled to the ground. I don't know. But he did have two handguns on him with additional magazines and a hunting knife. So unknown why that happened.
Did he fire both of those?
That's unknown at this time.
Did you find his car or anything in the parking lot? Have you taken that in for investigation or research for that? Because he got here somehow.
There is no car that we're looking for.
So you have a car then?
No. He didn't come here in his own car, if that's what you're asking.
Did he Uber here? How did he get to the
We're not going to release that right now. But he did make travel arrangements to come here and then had travel arrangements to get back to where he was going.
How many shots did he fire?
As far as we know, he was alone. And we're still trying to sift through all the evidence and stuff, but hopefully we'll have that for you in the next few days.
All right. So then if he didn't have a car, either traveled here on a bus or a plane, how would he bring the guns with him?
That's all part of the investigation. We'll let you know.
Did he have a bag? Just piggybacking on that, was it on his person, the weapons?
Not sure exactly how he got those guns into the venue right now. It's all part of the investigation.
The venue has signs that say no concealed weapons inside the venue. It's on the front door. Those signs look very new. Were they there prior to last night's event, or have those gone up since the event that took place last night?
Yeah, you'd have to ask the plaza about that.
Do you know if they did pat down this individual, or were they not checking people maybe after the concert had let out?
As far as I'm aware, there were no pat downs done to people entering. I'm unsure at this time. You'd have to ask the plaza about that.
Chief, is this shooting getting the same importance as other shootings in the city, or is this getting a high importance given the victim?
Well, I will say that our homicide detectives treat all of these homicides and shootings very, very seriously. And, you know, we work very hard to bring people to justice, to bring closure to the families in every single case. And I think that was evident, you know, especially with the homicide that they solved yesterday, the victim, Gino Nicholas.
So with the suspect in dying, was it suicide intentionally, or was it a stray bullet that just happened to dislodge from his weapon?
We believe at this time that he killed himself.
So intentionally,
yes. Yes. We believe at this time that he killed himself. Yes.
Can you tell us the type of handguns that we're dealing with?
Small caliber handguns. All right, thank you.